See, next type. Problems on guaranteed profit. Guarantee of profit. See, guarantee of profit is there. Either the total firm can give a guarantee. This lump sum amount, whether you earn less than it, we will manage and give. The total firm means, according to the profit sharing ratio, the partner should sacrifice certain share, certain amount to the newly admitted partner. So, or both the partners or one or two partners, according to their wish, they can sacrifice and fill the deficit amount to the newly admitted partner. So, what the deficiency will be there in the newly admitted partner, if that is owed, either a single partner according to the profit sharing ratio or according to their agreement, how much, or according to the lump sum amount, what the agreement is there, if according to that, for the newly admitted partner, if there is a deficit amount, if it is fulfilled by the partner or partners, that is the said to be the guarantee of profit. Here, guarantee of profit, in this problem, see, Sachin and Rahul were partners in a firm, sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. They admit Dhoni for 1/6 share, newly admitted partner share, if the lump sum amount is there. Lump sum amount is there, if according to the guaranteed amount, see, 1/6 share in profits and guaranteed debt is the share of profits will not be less than 25,000. Every year, 25,000 must and should go to the newly admitted partner in the name of the profit. That is the intention. 25,000, what the guarantee is given at the time of admission of a new partner, that amount should be given to the newly admitted partner at the end of each year. So, if it is equivalent, according to the profit sharing ratio, if it is equivalent amount, he got. So, in such circumstances, no need to sacrifice by any partner. If there is any deficiency, if there is less amount than the 25,000, in such circumstances, what the information is there, according to that, we have to allocate the money. Total profits of the firm were rupees 90,000. Here, in this problem, 90,000 total profit made. Calculate the share of profits for each partner when guarantee is given by a firm. By a firm means all the partners in their profit sharing ratio. In their own profit sharing ratio, they should sacrifice if there is a deficit. If there is a balance, no need to sacrifice. If there is deficit to the newly admitted partner, in such circumstances, all the partners according to their own profit sharing ratio, they should sacrifice and fulfill the less amount what is there. Or to balance how much amount is essential, that amount they should sacrifice according to their own profit sharing ratio. See, first, let us see. Let us bifurcate the actual amount of profit. The actual amount of profit, how much each partner will get. Before that, then, we should calculate the new profit sharing ratio. See, new profit sharing ratio. See, to calculate the new profit sharing ratio of all the partners, old partners as well as the new partner, there is nothing information is there. Here, old ratio is given and newly admitted partner's share is given. In such circumstances, we should consider the whole firm share is 1. Whole firm share is 1. So now, if firm share is equal to 1. If firm share is equal to 1, admitted partner share is equal to 1/6. How much remaining? When one share is there, firm share is 1. Out of 1/6 share is given to the newly admitted partner. How much remaining share is there? Remaining share is equal to 1 - 1/6 is equal to 5/6 is the remaining share. 5/6 is the remaining share. So now, Sachin's share. Sachin's equal to remaining shape. Into old shape. Remaining shape into old shape. So here remaining shape is 5 by 6 into old shape is 3 by 5 is equal to 15 by 13. 5 threes are 15, 6 fives are 13. So like that, Rahul's new shape is 10 by 30, 5 into 2, 10, 6 into 5, 30. And newly admitted partner, Dhoni's shape, already is given, is equal to 1 by 6. So, to get the common denominator, we should multiply by 5. Denominator must should be common. You should keep in your mind in the accounting terminology. All numerators is equal to one denominator. All numerators is equal to one denominator. So for that purpose is equal to 5 by 13. 5 by 13. 5 on the 5. 5 is the 13. So NPSR new coefficient is equal to 10. 15 is to 10 is to 5. Or when we simplify this, till the last digit, we have to simplify. 5 1 is 5 2 is 5 3 is. So, 3 is to 2 is to 1. This is the new profit sharing ratio. Keep in your mind, this is the new profit sharing ratio. When the information is not given, in such circumstances, we should take firms, complete firm share is 1. And we have to deduct the admitted partner share, we will get the remaining share. In that, with that remaining share, we should, if we multiply the old share of the old partners, we will get the new profit sharing ratio. After finding out the new profit sharing ratio, we should allocate the profit. We should allocate the actual profit, how much each partner will get, including the new partner. See, allocation of actual profit to all partners. See, first one, Sachin. See, total profit how much is there? Firm's profit is 90,000. 90,000 into new profit sharing ratio is equal to 3 by 6 is equal to 45,000. 45,000. So I will write it. Sachin is equal to 90,000 into 3 by 6 is equal to 45,000. Second, Rahul is equal to 90,000 into 2 by 6 is equal to 30,000, and Dhoni is equal to 90,000 into 1 by 6 is equal to 15,000. See, this is the actual profit. If there is no guarantee to the Dhoni, if there is no norms and conditions in the agreement, so these are the profits should be allocated to the partners. And that will be credited to the partner's capital account. So, but here, there is a guarantee of 25,000. Here is 15,000 is there. How much less? 10,000 is the deficit amount plus 10,000. Is equal to now it will become 25,000. So this 10,000 what is there? 10,000 what is there? This will be given by old partners according to their old profit sharing ratio. That is 3:2. So now deficiency borne by old partners. Deficiency is 10,000. 10,000 is the deficiency. So this is Sachin is equal to 10,000 into old ratio is 3/5. That is 6,000. That is 6,000. And Rahul 10,000 into 2/5, that is 4,000. So deduct from the actual profit minus 6,000 is equal to 39,000 minus 4,000 is equal to 26,000. Overall, how much? That is 90,000. Now, see 39,000, 26,000, 25,000 now allocated. But the actual profit is 45,000, 30,000, 15,000. Deficiency borne by Sachin is 6,000. Deficiency borne by Rahul is 4,000. And gain to the Dhoni is 10,000. Now, profit and loss of operation account. By profit and loss account, 90,000 is there. Profit and loss account, 90,000 is there. So, to Sachin's account, 45,000 minus 6,000. That is 39,000 to Sachin's capital account. Rahul's capital account, that is 30,000 minus 4,000, 26,000 to Dhoni. Dhoni's capital account 15,000 plus 10,000 25,000. Transfer. Say. The same, in the continuation of the same, already we find out 45,000, 30,000 and the 15,000 is the actual profit. But deficiency borne by Sachin is 6,000, deficiency borne by Rahul is 4000 but gained by Dhoni is 10,000. So 45,000 minus 6,000, 39,000. 30,000 minus 4,000, 26,000. And Dhoni's capital 15,000 actual amount plus guaranteed amount. To the extent of the 25,000, the gap should be filled. That gap will be filled by two partners, that is 10,000, 25,000. Overall profit is 90,000.